Hello from Health Check. This month we have a special focus on living with HIV. Developing a vaccine to protect people against the virus is challenging scientists all over the world, including those that Ben Tavener went to visit in São Paulo.
It's still one of the deadliest diseases on the planet. Left unchecked, HIV attacks the immune system, leaving people vulnerable to even minor diseases and infections. For the last 25 years, scientists have been working on finding a way to fight back, but a vaccine against HIV remains stubbornly out of reach. Currently, some 30 different projects around the world have reached human clinical trials. Researchers at USP, the University of São Paulo, have been working on their vaccine since 2002. Their approach aims to trigger helper T cells, a key weapon in the body's immune defense.
Vaccines that are currently being tested in the HIV field can be one of several formats. So one is a recombinant protein, the other is a recombinant DNA, and the other is a recombinant viral vector. Ideally, a vaccine should induce antibody responses, antibodies that could neutralize the virus, and T cell responses that would inhibit the replication of viruses.
HIV vaccines introduce fragments of the virus into the body to elicit an immune response. Professor Cunhunato and his team have identified 18 fragments of HIV that are commonly recognized by the body. They use this information to create a DNA-based vaccine, and initial tests in animals have been far better than expected.
The USP vaccine it aims at several targets. It aims at eliciting responses of CD4 positive T cells, which are the most important cells of the immune response. The second point is that it's targeted to conserved regions of HIV, so it's most likely we'll be able to induce an effective response to the variable HIV.
The team says their vaccine stimulates the production of helper T cells, allowing the body to coordinate its attack on HIV. Scientists here hope that their latest tests will identify the best form to deliver the vaccine into the body to trigger the most effective immune response in future human trials. And the team knows there's not a moment to spare.
According to the UN, the number of new HIV infections across the world has gone down, but here in Brazil, it's on the up. Between 2005 and 2013, the number increased more than 10%. That means the work being done here at the University of São Paulo is all the more poignant.
Elcio is one of 800,000 people living with HIV in Brazil. Although this vaccine may be 3 to 4 years from human trials, a number of volunteers, including his friend Enio, have come forward wanting to take part.
Firstly, it was a personal choice for me. I have another friend who told me he had HIV about 2 years ago. People really lack knowledge about HIV, especially how it spread. With the vaccine, people just need more information on the process.
I've been HIV positive for 2 years. People need to come together on this quest for a vaccine. I'd be really pleased if people came forward to take part. I think first and foremost, a vaccine would benefit people who don't have access to healthcare, sanitation, or information on HIV.
Volunteers will play a key role in the next step towards producing an effective vaccine to defeat HIV once and for all.